Hello friends, welcome to Tech Study Cell. In this video, we will make a very useful IoT project using the ESP8266 and Blynk to control the appliances with sensor and timer. And we will also connect the Google Assistant with Blynk to control the relays. And apart from that, you can control the appliances with the Blynk IoT app, IR remote, and also from the manual switches. And with this project, you can also set the time delay for any appliances from your smartphone, which we'll see during the video. And before starting, let me tell you, I have used all the free tools for this project, so everything is free. And during the video, I have shared the circuit, source code, and all other required details so that you can easily make this project for your home. Now, as you can see, you can easily make the circuit without using any PCB. But still, I will recommend you to always make the circuit on PCB or zero PCB to avoid any loose connection. And you can easily design professional PCBs for your any electronics project with Altium PCB designing software. Altium is a very well-known and most trusted PCB designing software. The user interface is so simple that you can easily design any complex PCB in Altium. And it also provides a lot of useful tools and features for routing, which will save you a lot of time, and you will find a lot of details tutorial which will help you to use this software to make professional PCB very easily. So I will highly recommend you to download the free trial version of the Altium software from video description, and later on, if you like this software, you can purchase it. First, I will control the lamps with Google Assistant.
Hey Google,
turn on study lamp.
Turning on the study lamp.
Hey Google,
turn on room light.
Turning on the room light.
And you can also use Blynk IoT app to control the appliances. Let me turn off all the lamp. You can use this button. Now let me use the IR remote to control the appliances, and you can monitor the real-time feedback. And with this button, you can turn off all the lamps together. Now let me use the manual switch. You can also use push button, and you can always monitor the real-time feedback. Now let me show you the automation I have added. So if I tap on the automation, here you can see I have added total 3 automation. So first let me show you the timer control automation I have added for the 4th relay. Let me tap on it. So here you can see if I turn on the 4th relay, is on is written. Then it will remain turned on for 1 minute. So 1 minute is the time delay. Then it will automatically turn off the 4th relay. And you can always change this time delay from your smartphone. Let me show you. If I tap on it, then I have to select the timer. And from here I can set the time delay. Let me make the time delay 10 seconds. So here you can see I have selected 10 seconds. Now I will tap on OK. Then I will tap on done. So now the time delay is 10 seconds. I will save this automation. Now if I turn on the 4th relay, it will remain turned on for 10 seconds, then it will turn off automatically. So this is a stopwatch. So I will turn on the 4th relay, and I will also turn on the stopwatch. The relay should turn off after 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, the relay automatically turns off. Now with the first and second automation, I can control the third relay with the DS11 sensor. So let me go to the dashboard. Now if I increase the temperature with a dryer, you can see the temperature is increasing and the relay turns on. You can see the lamp turns on, and I have also received a notification in mobile. Let me close it, and you can see the lamp turns on. So as per the automation, whenever the temperature crosses 40 degrees Celsius, the third lamp will automatically turn on, and it will automatically turn off whenever the temperature becomes below 35 degrees Celsius. You can see the lamps automatically turns off, and now the temperature is 34.8 degrees Celsius. Now here, as you can see, the blue LED is glowing, which indicates now the NodeMCU is connected with the Blynk cloud. But if it is not connected with the Wi-Fi, still you can control these appliances with the IR remote and also from the manual switches. So this is a very useful project. So without any further delay, let's make it. These are the components for this project. Here I have used the NodeMCU, and you have to use the I receiver with the metallic case. I have used 188 I receiver, and you can use any I remote. And for manual control, either you can use latch switch or push buttons. Now you have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have given the 5 volt supply to NodeMCU, relay module and a sensor. And here for the manual control, I have used push buttons, which is connected across the GPIO pin and the ground pin. But if you want, you can also use latch switches instead of the push button. But if you use latch switch, then switch 2, which is connected with the D3 GPIO, must be turned off during the restart or programming the NodeMCU. So this is a limitation if you use latch switch, but if you use push button, there is no such limitations. The circuit is very simple, you can easily make it, but still, just to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for this project. And as I said, you can easily design professional PCB using Altium PCB designing software. You can find the download link in the description. So in this project, we are going to use this PCB, and here you can see I have connected the DST11 sensor and the I receiver with the PCB according to the circuit. Now before programming the NodeMCU, we have to configure the Blynk Cloud account. So let me log in to Blynk Cloud. After login, I will go to templates, and here you can see we have created this ESP32 automation template in my previous project. I will duplicate this template, and here I will give the name, and in the hardware I will select ESP8266. In the data stream, I will use V1 to V4 to control the 4 relay, and I will use V5 to turn off all the relay together. And the last two data stream will be used for the DST11 sensor. Now if I go to automation, then here you can see I will use third and fourth relay in this automation. I will use the temperature reading to control the third relay. So accordingly, I have turned on the condition and action button. And this is the web dashboard. In my previous video, I have already shown you how to create this template. You can refer that video, link in description. Now I will click on save to save the template. So our template is ready. Now I will go to device. So I will click here. Then I will click on new device. Then I will select from template. And here I will select the template we have created just now, NodeMCU automation. And you can change the device name. I am keeping as it is. Now click on create. So our device is ready. Now if I go to device info, then you will get all the details which will be required in the code. Now I will define the automation for this project. Here you can see the automation icon in the Blynk Cloud account. Let me click on it. In my previous project, I have shown you how you can define automation from the Blynk IoT app. Here I will define the automation from the Blynk Cloud account. So you can use either Blynk IoT app or Blynk Cloud account to define the automation. So first I will create the automation for the third relay to control it with the temperature. So let me click on device state. Then you have to enter the device name. Then select the data stream. Here I will select temperature. Then I will select is greater than. Then I will enter the value 40 degrees Celsius. After that, I will click on control device and select NodeMCU automation. Then I want this switch 3 data stream to turn on. Then I want to send a notification, say high temperature. And I will name this automation temp on. Now I will save it. Now I will quickly create another automation. So I will click on create automation, and again I will select device state. Now with this automation, I want the third relay to turn off whenever the temperature comes below 35 degrees Celsius. So I will select the device name, then I will select the data stream temperature, and now I will select less than, and I will enter the value 35. Then I will click on control device and select the device name. Again, I will select switch 3
and this time I will turn off this radio button and I will name this automation temp off. Now in the third automation, I will define a timer for the fourth relay. So with this automation, whenever I turn on the fourth relay, it will remain turned on for 2 minutes. After that, it will automatically turn off. So let me click on create automation again. And here I will select device state. Then you can see I have selected the device name. And here I will select the data stream switch 4. So I want whenever this relay turns on, so I have selected is on. After that, here I will click on wait and do something, and here I will select a timer. So I want this relay to turn on say for 1 minute. You can select any time limit here as per your requirement. Here I have selected 1 minute, so the relay will be turned on till 1 minute. Then I will click on this control device and select NodeMCU automation, and again I will select the switch 4, and this time I will turn off this radio button as I want this relay to turn off after 1 minute, and I will name this automation say timer control. Now I will save it. Thus you can easily define the automation from the Blynk cloud account, and you can always turn the automation off or on both from Blynk cloud and Blynk IoT app. These are the source code for this project. You can download all these codes from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download all the codes from these buttons. After downloading, first you have to upload this code to NodeMCU to get all the hex code from IR remote buttons. Here I have connected the IR receiver with the SD2, which is GPIO 9 of the NodeMCU. Then open the serial monitor and select the baud rate 9600. Now if you press any button of the IR remote, the related hex code will populate in the serial monitor. Thus you can easily get the hex code of the IR remote buttons, and in my previous video I have already explained this process. Now these are the main sketch for this project. If you use latch switch, then you have to upload this code to NodeMCU. You can find the switch in the code name, and for the buttons you have to upload this code. Let me open the code for the buttons. For this project you have to install all these libraries. Then you have to update the Blynk template ID, device name and authentication token. For that you have to go to Blynk account. So if you go to my device, then you have to go to device you have added, and then go to device info. You will get all these details. Just click here to copy this and then go to Arduino sketch and here paste it. After that I will mention the Wi-Fi credential. So here I will mention the Wi-Fi name, then Wi-Fi password. Then you can make this variable true if you want to fetch the previous state from the Blynk cloud whenever the NodeMCU connects with the Blynk. And if you make it false, then it will update the current state to Blynk cloud whenever the NodeMCU connects with the Blynk. So you have to update this variable according to your requirement. After that, you have to update all the hex code of the IR remote buttons. Now if you refer the same circuit, then you can directly upload this code after doing these changes. So go to tools, then select a board as NodeMCU 1.0 and proper port, then hit the upload button.
After programming the NodeMCU, you can see this blue LED is glowing, which indicates now the NodeMCU is connected with the Blynk server. Now let me open the Blynk IoT app. And this is our device, NodeMCU automation. Let me tap on it, and here you can see our mobile dashboard is ready, as here I have used a clone template from my previous project. So let me go to the setting, and here you can see we have already configured this dashboard in my previous project with ESP32. You can find a video link in the description. And if I tap on the first button, here you can see the mode is switched. So for the first 4 button, I have selected the mode switch, and for the 5th button, here you can see mode is push. I have used this 5th button to turn off all the relays together, and these 2 gauge widgets for the DST11 sensor. Let me exit from this dashboard, And here you can see, if I go to automation, you can control all the automation we have created from the Blynk IoT app. Now to connect the Blynk IoT platform with the Google Assistant, I have used IFTTT. Here I have used free account of the IFTTT, so I have created only 4 applet. With that you can control only 2 appliances with the Google Assistant. In my previous video, I have already explained how you can use the IFTTT to connect the Blynk Cloud with the Google Assistant. So here you can see, this is the API syntax for the new Blynk IoT platform. First, you have to update the server address. You can get the region in the Blynk account. Here you can see this is the region, and accordingly you can select the server address. After that, you have to enter the authentication token. You can get the authentication token under the device info. This is the authentication token. So the syntax is very simple. I have used these URLs for this project. You can see this is the authentication token and the server address. So you just have to update these 2 value, and you can refer my previous video on IFTTT. You can find the link in the description.
Now let me connect the appliances with this PCB according to this circuit.
If you like this project, then please give a thumbs up, and I will really appreciate if you support us on Patreon. You can find the link in the description. And for more such projects, please do subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.